Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to my videos after Ramadan and Eid. Today I was supposed to continue the series that I started before Ramadan, but the recent events, what's happening and the racism elevation on many levels drove me to start this new short series about equality from Islamic point of view. So in this short series, I will focus on equality from Islamic perspective and how did Islam fight against racism from Quran and Sunnah and the stories of the Sahaba, the companion of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and even the people after that from Islamic history. So let's do that. First, we look at the Quran. The Quran mentioned equality many times in the forms of equality between people, equality in the whole universe, and similarities, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything in the perfect way. But two ayat I want to call out. The first ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to all mankind, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ O mankind, we created you from male and female. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created different genders. And we created you شعوباً وقبائل, different people, different races and different tribes. Why? لِتَعَارَفُوا So you know each other and you merge together, and that is the purpose of creating people in different races and in different colors. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ The best of you is the one that has more good deeds in front of Allah. The one that is better person in their manners, in their deeds, not in their colors, not in any other form. Allah says in the end of the ayah, He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knows the best. That's ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, chapter 49, verse 13. And the second ayah, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالَمِينَ That's ayah 22 in chapter 30 from Surah Ar-Rum. So it says it's from the signs and the evidences of the universe that Allah created, that He created these skies, earths, heavens, and He created us humans from different races, speaking different languages, and from different colors. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالَمِينَ That by itself is from the signs of Allah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable of creating us brown, white, black, yellow, all colors, and it's from the signs that we should recognize the ability of Allah not to be picky and to think there is a color better than the other color or there is people better than other people except for the people who do better in front of Allah. These are the ayat that talk about equality among many other ayat in the Quran. But what about Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? He said way too many ahadith that emphasize the importance of equality. I want to call out two hadiths also. There's the first hadith Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, ليس لعربي فضل على أعجمي إلا بالتقوى. An Arab is not better than non-Arab or أعجمي, meaning a black person specifically. Arab is not better than a non-Arab or a black person by any mean except the taqwa. If he's a better person in his work to Allah in his good deeds, it's always the taqwa that measures who is better. And it's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to decide. So that clearly says Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is Arab and he is the messenger to all mankind, stating that it's not about race, it's not about color. He said that in Medina, stating to all his companions. The other hadith that I want to say, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that لينتهي أقوام there will be people after you, meaning لينتهي أقوام يفتخرون بآبائهم, they feel a pride about their pioneers, about their fathers who died, who passed away, and those will be the charcoal of the hellfire. Those are حَقَبُ جَهَنَّمْ, as mentioned in the hadith. This is a hadith with the Hassan Isnad, is a good authentication in Tirmidhi. And the first hadith I forget to mention, it's a hadith Sahih Rawahu Ahmed. So the second hadith says that those people who are proud of who they are, who are proud of their fathers, because, oh, my fathers are from so and so, or I'm from such a tribe and so on, they are, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, they are the charcoal of the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam could not use any stronger language to emphasize the importance of equality and being against racism in the ahadith that he mentioned than those two ahadith. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. In the next video, I'm going to share with you stories that happened in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and afterwards with his companion, that emphasized how these people lived their lives, emphasizing the equality and what did they do to promote the equality and being against racism. And I leave you with one quote for Benjamin Franklin. He said once, "Justice will not be served till those who are non-affected are as outraged as those who are." If you like this video, and if you want to see the next couple of videos about the same topic, I encourage you to share this with your Muslims and non-Muslim contacts, and I will see you in the next episode.